Hi, my name is Kevin Devery, and we're at Mobile World Congress 2025 in Barcelona. And here I'm talking about a demo we're doing in partnership with Samsung and Dell on the Intel Xeon 6 SoC. So a number of different components to this demo, and I'm going to take you through them briefly to showcase the best that we have for next generation virtualized RAN networks. So first, our own product announcement recently was the Intel Xeon 6 SoC. This is a part that comes with up to 72 P cores, integrated vRAN boost for your layer one processing, and integrated Ethernet to help with fan out for the front haul and back haul required in a RAN network. The latest and greatest chip is showing us that we can get up to 2.4x capacity within a single server, as well as up to a 70% performance per watt improvement over the previous generation. The real benefits that drives for operators is that in previous generations, we would see that you'd need two, maybe even three servers for a deployment, and now we're able to reduce that down to a single server for the vast majority of deployments, bringing massive TCO benefits, not just on the CapEx and the physical hardware you're buying, but also on the OpEx and the efficiency that you're able to drive out of the silicon to support the increased capacity. The other major benefit, and one of the key items we had in mind when we were designing the Intel Xeon 6 SoC, was to make sure that AI was at its core. So in every single P core in this processor, we've got the Intel AMX instructions, which provide fantastic performance for inferencing workloads, and particularly for RAN AI models, we're seeing up to about a 3.2x improvement per core for those models. Meaning that when you're moving to the next generation, you're going to be able to get the best AI solutions running in your vRAN networks from partners such as Samsung. The other part that we're doing here in partnership with Samsung running on our Intel Xeon 6 SoC is that they provided us with a sample deployment of 24 FDD cells running on one of our pre-release systems. And that's supporting the 24 cells that I'd mentioned on about 53% of that CPU, so roughly 22 cores, leaving an additional 20 cores free for other functions or for increased capacity. And given that we're able to scale this processor up to at least 72 P cores, that means you've got a significant amount of headroom to provide not just additional FDD cells, but moving into massive MIMO cells as well to cover every type of deployment that you could see in the future. What's important when you're deploying vRAN is you've got the right type of platform to deploy it on, and that's why we have an XR8000 here next to us today. So this is the current generation XR8620T. From Dell, showcasing the Sapphire Rapids EE, or fourth gen Intel Xeon processor with our EA10 NICs. Of course, this is one of the solutions that you'll see in the market today, supporting the current generation of vRAN deployments. And it's an example of a form factor that provides ample benefits for vRAN from both the cooling capacity it can provide, but also the fan out of IO that you can support, enabling a large array of radios to be connected on your front haul and a couple of ports left over for your back haul. On this side of the demo, we have an AI example use case with Samsung. So this is an AI supported channel estimation model. Samsung took an image denoising model similar to what you'd use for upscaling in images and tried to apply it to the signals coming back from users at a cell edge. Those signals are typically quite noisy due to the environment that they're operating in and due to the range from the base station and the radio site itself. Because those signals are so noisy, you can lead to lower performance and worse KPIs for the end user, and typically it'll result in those one or two bar scenarios that you'll have on your phone. With this technology, we're able to see a 12% improvement in the wireless capacity when you're at that cell edge. So this isn't just about, these products aren't just about increasing the capacity on the platform, but also providing a significantly improved user experience, no matter whether you're at the peak performance location in the cell, or right at that cell edge, making sure that you've got connectivity no matter where you go.